The next operation that's important is to understand how to scale a vector. Scaling, we're going to see, is going to be the same as stretching a vector. Let's have a look. We'll do so by first looking at an example. Here we have a vector x, which has components 4 and minus 3. What happens if we lay this vector x head to toe with itself? We have seen in the last unit that that means that we compute x plus x, which in this case then means 8 minus 6. Now let's look at this in a slightly different way. We start with vector x, but now we stretch it so that it becomes twice as long. Notice that we're not going to change the direction, we're simply going to change its length. What we see is that the net effect is the same as laying x head to toe, because here we stretch the vector by a factor 2. Notice that in the process, all that happened was that the first component was doubled, and the second component was doubled. Now, what if we take that same vector, but now we stretch it by a factor negative 1/2? What we get now is a vector that points in the opposite direction. That's because we chose to scale it by a negative number. And also notice that the vector now is half as long, and that's because we chose the scaling factor to be negative 1/2. Each of the components now has been halved, but also negated. What if we start with a vector x of size n, and we scale it by some real number alpha? Then alpha times x is just alpha times the vector with all of its components exposed. And to scale it, all we need to do is multiply each of the separate components by the scaling factor alpha. What if instead we want an algorithm that computes vector y as the stretched vector x stretched by a scaling factor alpha? Y becomes alpha times x. We expose the components of y, and notice that here I used the wrong Greek letter. I should have used psi 0, psi 1, and psi n minus 1. We need to compute alpha times x, where here we expose the individual components of x. And all we need to do is set the appropriate element of y to the corresponding element of x scaled by alpha. If we do this as an algorithm, then what we need to do is set psi I equal to alpha times chi I. Remember that all of this should have been psi 0, psi 1, and through psi n minus 1. And then we need a for loop so that this happens for each of the components of y. So, to summarize, scaling a vector x by alpha geometrically means stretching that vector by a factor alpha. This creates a new vector in the same direction of x, but with its length scaled by alpha. Computing alpha times x means that each component of x is multiplied by alpha.